All right, we're here at the National Farm Machinery Show talking to Strategic Marketing Services President and owner Jerry Golke and also our marketing strategy columnist for Top Producer. But Jerry, let's talk about the Top Producer acreage survey that you just looked at here. And it looks like we're going to see at least probably an increase in soybean acres for next year, and that seems to be consistent with what you're hearing.
Yes, and I think if one takes a look at cash flows, anybody that doesn't get at least 160, 170 bushel of corn struggles with being able to make it cash flow. What I found in looking at the survey as well as in making seminars is that the fringe states of the corn states, in other words, the non-I states, Illinois, Iowa, Indiana, and of course Minnesota, are probably going to go to more beans because of they can't grow 200 bushel corn. And I was just recently in North Dakota. We've seen it there. They're concerned about getting in the field in the Red River Valley. So already they've made commitments to look at maybe a 20% switch there. What is interesting about your survey and the ones I've seen is that in the same question that's asked, will you switch? The same answer to the question of did you buy your fertilizer seems to be an underlying thread in that some will say I bought 40-75% of my fertilizer, and if you look at it, they're thinking about switching 20-25% of their corn to beans, indicating that I paid a lot of money for fertilizer before. I probably don't want to do that on the rest of my crop. So if fertilizer were to drop precipitously in the next month or so, then that might change somewhat.
So would it be a safe bet to say that right now when we look at that March report when it comes out on the 30th, I mean, could we be looking at something that maybe isn't that accurate?
Well, I think, again, the spring weather is going to be important because in northern Illinois we've got a lot of field work to do and so do a lot of other people, and no fertilizer put down in northern Illinois. Very few people did anything last fall, so will we be able to get it all done in time? And that's weather again always. So I think we probably won't know for sure until June 30th, because what we intend to do on March 1st and what we really end up doing could be a 5% difference. And if you look at 5% of the crop, that's 4 million acres of corn that could swing one way or the other, or beans. So it's going to be a crapshoot, I think, all the way through, depending on the weather. But the indications right now are that we're going to have more beans, less wheat. Certainly the spring wheat's going to take a hit in North Dakota. And, of course, that'll all go to beans, perhaps, or bean equivalents, and less corn. We just don't know how much. One thing important of what's going on in the marketplace is that we can probably do without as much corn as we did last year, in spite of what some people think, if we get an average crop due to less ethanol being used and less cattle on feed and probably less hogs. So we don't need as much. So we can lose 2 million acres of corn and it won't bother to market any.
What's the game then? What's your play for the markets?
Well, we've been going sideways here since, you know, about the first of the year. We had a little rally, or quite a bit rally, in December, and I think you have to watch if we're going to break out to one direction or another. And again, the economic situation is going to be critical. The Dow Jones doesn't seem to want to hang in there very well. If we see that break out to the downside and making new lows over last year, then the traders or the people in the world will look at this and say, like we're seeing in crude oil, you can cut production, but it doesn't matter because we're lowering demand worldwide faster than we're lowering production. And there's a big debate out there, as you know, that between production destruction and demand destruction, which is going to be greater. And there's more and more research surfacing now that some of our foreign countries won't have money for fertilizer, maybe, and machinery and so forth. So if we can lower production worldwide a little bit, then that would help us all. But as USDA told me once in December, if we get a rally in grain prices, who's going to buy it? There's nothing you can do with $5 corn, the comment was. You can't burn it, you can't eat it, and you can't export it. So if we get a rally due to acres or weather that now or next summer, we have to remember that this is not last year. You don't have $140 crude oil to use $5 corn.
All right, Jerry, thank you very much. That's Jerry Golke with Strategic Marketing Services.